this. No more pretense. No games. Just you, me, and the truth.
What do you know about the truth? You bend the truth into whatever shape suits you.
Judge Sisko hands down another ruling. But where's his evidence?
All right. You really want to do this? Here.
Now?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, let's do it! You were prefect of Bajor during the occupation, true or false?
True.
And you were responsible for everything that happened under your command, true or false?
True.
So that means that you are responsible for the murder of over 5 million Bajorans on your watch, true or false?
False! I tried to save lives during my administration.
Evidence!
Evidence! He wants evidence! By the time I became prefect, the occupation had been going on for almost 40 years. But the plan still wasn't ready for full-scale colonization. Central Command wanted the situation resolved, and they didn't care how it was done. I was convinced that a gentler hand was required to deal with the Bajorans.
It was a noble, if misguided, vision.
So in my first official act as prefect, I ordered all labor camp commanders to reduce their output quotas by 50%. Then I reorganized the camps themselves. Child labor was abolished. Medical care was improved. Food rations were increased. At the end of 1 month of my administration, the death rate had dropped by 20%. Now, how did the Bajorans react to all this? On my 1 month anniversary, they blew up an orbital dry dock, killing over 200 Cardassian soldiers and workers.
We didn't want a reconciliation. We wanted to destroy you.
So I had to order a response. But even then, it was a carefully tempered one. I ordered 200 suspected members of the resistance rounded up and executed. 200 lives for 200 lives. That's justice, not malevolence. Justice.
Dominion would have never been so generous.
But did I give up my efforts to reach out to the Bajorans? No. I tried again. And what did I get for my troubles? An assassination attempt on my own station. Another round of executions followed. Once again, courtesy of the Bajoran resistance.
We never wanted peace. We hated you. We hated all of you.
On and on it went, year after blood-soaked year. Time and again, I would reach out with an open hand of friendship, and time and again, they would slap it away.
The Bajorans understand a clenched fist, not an open hand.
Being reasonable only made us bolder.
The Dominion would have killed every man, woman, and child on Bajor long ago.
I hope you're listening to all this.
Oh, believe me, you have my undivided attention. Now, let me get this straight. You're not responsible for what happened during the occupation. The Bajorans are.
Hmm? Yes. Yes, exactly.
So, why do you think they didn't appreciate this rare opportunity you were offering them?
Oh, because they were blind, ignorant fools. If only they had cooperated with us, we could have turned their world into a paradise. From the moment we arrived on Bajor, it was clear that we were the superior race. But they couldn't accept that. They wanted to be treated as equals, when they most certainly were not. Militarily, technologically, culturally. We were almost a century ahead of them in every way. We did not choose to be the superior race. Fate handed us that role. And it would have been so much easier on everyone if the Bajorans had simply accepted their role. But no. Day after day, they clustered in the temples and prayed for deliverance. And night after night, they planted bombs outside of our homes. Pride. Stubborn, unyielding pride.